everybody, hope you're doing well. Welcome back to another video. I have been wanting to read this book, well, the whole series, but specifically this book, for a very, very long time. I remember that I ordered the book from like WHMF. It was like the cheapest place I could find it, like a long time ago. This was like 3 or 4 years maybe before I actually started like reading properly. It's like I'm gonna start my reading era, but I just like put it away and forgot about it, but now I am in my reading era, clearly. I need to read it. I've wanted to read it for so long, and it is the inspiration for one of my favorite like queer teen films. I think one of the first as well. It was one of the first that I remember watching myself, where it was sort of just like a teen film and there was a queer character in it, and I was just like so happy. I just felt so seen, and like there's a certain part that it makes me, oh, I cry every single time. But also what I thought was weird before I get it out is that I was just like looking on Snapchat, just because I rarely ever go on there, just to see the filters, and I went on the AI thing, and I thought I'd just, you know, say hi to them if they're, you know, not real. And they was like, oh, you're just having a chill day, I'll just put the thing here, like, do you want a book recommendation? And I was like, you know what, all right then, maybe this won't be the video that I was planning, and I'll just do an AI recommends me a book video again, sort of. And it recommended me Simonverse Sahopia Sapia Gender, which is what I'm reading in this video, if you didn't know the title. Which I just felt was so weird. I don't know, maybe it's like my phone's eyes, like, I haven't said it out loud though, that's the thing. Like, does it just like know my brain? I don't know. That was like sort of weird and creepy, but anywho, I'm gonna get that out, start reading, and I'll give you updates as we go along. I'm so excited. Yay!
YA, it's red, so it'll be behind here. Yes, I double stacked, but I make it like special. It's like on a platform, so it's not, you know, it's not heathen behaviour. But anyway, let's get it out. Sorry, I'm showing you my arm. Oh, come on. Oh, yeah, why am I doing this right now? Like, I could just put my phone down and avoid all of this hassle. But anyway, here we are. Ta-da! I love that film. I'll watch it probably in this video after.
I tell a lie, I actually did start it. Apparently I got to page 16, so we're starting again anyway. That is an old napkin. Also, I didn't tell you who it's by. It's by Becky, Albertalli. Let's go.
Hey, so I went out and I was reading the book, started it. I'm on to page 108. It's quite good. I've enjoyed it so far. It's actually a little bit different from the film, Love, Simon. Like some subtle changes, like he has an older sister in it, she was at university. And just the way certain things happen isn't exactly the same. I have watched the film many, many times. I love it. So I do know who Blue is. But it's still fun to, you know, go through it with him and trying to like work out. I haven't told you what it's about, have I? But it's basically following Simon Spear, and he was doing emails with another closeted gay guy at his school. They're juniors, so I think they're like 16, 17 age, and there was like emailing back and forth, and then Martin, who was another student, saw the emails after he like logged out, but he didn't really log out before he did. Not on purpose, I don't think, but yeah, and he sort of blackmailed on him so he can try and get Martin with his like new friend Abby, and they also, the friend Leah and Nick, they're all the same characters, and that is sort of how it's going along. And he doesn't really want, obviously, for Martin to share the screenshots or of the emails for himself, because he's not ready to come out yet, but at the same time he doesn't want to push Blue away, and he'll know that he won't be like there for him anymore, because they have like a good bond, and it's like very important for him to have this space to express himself and, you know, talk about things that he doesn't really feel that open with other people. So yeah, so we're just, he's sort of trying to work it out, and he's just like going along. And we're up to like December time now, the start of December. And I don't know if it happens in this, but I know what happens in the film on Christmas Day. And I'm just trying to prepare myself because I'm like, oh. But yeah, I'll tell you more later when I get more through it. So I've currently got to page 270. There's like about 30 pages of the actual book, and then there's like bonus content at the back. It's like coming up to 315. I was gonna finish it tonight, but I'm really tired, so I'm here to sleep, finish it in the morning, and then, you know, tell you more about it. But I'm finding quite a few more differences from the film, which is quite fun, because obviously I didn't want it to be an exact replica, and I knew like everything scene for scene. But yeah. I'll talk to you in the morning. So I finished this. I really enjoyed it. But now I'm going to watch the film of Love, Simon, because I really, really want to. Like, just reading this just ignited all these, like, memories from, like, 2018, 2019 when I watched it. So I'm going to do that. I think I might actually, like, show a few bits over the next portion. There might be, like, spoilers for the film and sort of the book. But I'll give you a proper review of this after I finish that, because that's what I want to do now, so.
It's an invisible line that I have to cross to really be a part of everything, and I can't ever cross it.
I feel that way sometimes, too.
Maybe it's because it doesn't seem fair that only gay people have to come out. Why is straight the default?
I'm heterosexual.
I'm gay.
Oh.
So you knew?
No.
But you're not surprised.
Do you want me to be surprised?
I don't know.
Okay. Well, I love you.
You just here to check out the packages.
Didn't your mother ever tell you not to grab your micro penis in public? Can we get some hummus for that baby Karen?
Yes.
I'll take it from here.
Hey, Miss Albright.
Don't hey, Miss Albright me. We're not friends. You're not going to braid my hair or paint my nails. Get your ass off the table now. You sweaty, hormonal virgins. You know what? You're about to be suspended for so long that by the time it's over, you're going to be the fat, bald, unhappily married, wildly mediocre nobodies you're destined to become. You can't talk to us like that. Actually, I can. Because I just did. And you know why? Because you're just those two assholes that did that shitty thing in front of the whole school. And guess what? Nobody feels sorry for those assholes. Especially me. Now walk. Mr. Wirt's office, now. That's my now. I'm gonna sell it. Get my tubes hot.
My mom still tells my grandparents about all the girls I'm dating when we go over to their house for dinner every Sunday. She says it's because they're old and religious. It's just easier that way. Darn, maybe that's true. But you should hear her voice when she talks about the girls.
I don't care if you didn't think that my coming out was gonna be a big thing, Martin. Look, you don't get to decide that. I'm supposed to be the one that decides when and where and how and who knows and how I get to say it. That's supposed to be my thing. And you took that away from me. So look, can you please just get the fuck away from me?
I need you to hear this. You are still you, Simon. You are still the same son who I love to tease. And who your father depends on for just about everything. And you're the same brother who always compliments his sister on her food, even when it sucks. You get to exhale now, Simon. You get to be more you than you have been in a very long time. You deserve everything you want.
In case the message got lost somewhere, I just want you to know that I love you. I'm really proud of you. I wouldn't change anything about you. I thought maybe we could sign up for Grindr together. You don't know what Grindr is, do you? It's Facebook for gay people. Not what it is. Truth is, I was just scared. First, I thought it was just a gay thing. But then I realized no matter what, announcing who you are to the world is pretty terrifying. Because what if the world doesn't like you? So I did whatever I could to keep my secret. I hurt the best, most important people, and I want them to know that I'm sorry. I am done being scared. I'm done living in a world where I don't get to be who I am. I deserve a great love story.
This is the review portion for the book. I really, really enjoy it. So I think I'm going to give it about a 4.25 star rating. I don't really think I have anything else to say about the plot that would be like spoilers, but we're basically just following Simon with his friends, and he's trying to navigate this situation that he's been put in. And also, I guess, sort of like the other parts of being a teenager, about like thinking about your future and your different relationships with your friends and family and, you know, just moving on. But I do think it like really paints the picture well of how, like, even though you have this part of you inside you that you're wanting to, you know, not share, it's not because you feel ashamed of it per se, it's more because you're scared of how the news might impact your relationships with your friends and families. And despite thinking that it's going to be all fine and good and dandy, there's still a part of you that's like, what if? And that's a very scary place to be, and I know that. I think it really ties the line well of being humorous and, you know, lighthearted, as well as being quite emotional and having those nitbits. But yeah, I really, really enjoyed this. I think I do prefer the film. I feel like this has a little bit more drama, and I like some more scenes in there, especially like when he's talking with his parents. That just every single time I watch that, I get like goosebumps all the way up my arms. I just love it so much. Like, oh, amazing. Maybe some of the magic of unraveling the story was taken away because I'd watched the film before, so I already knew. But at the same time, it was still a very, very enjoyable and like fun reading experience, and it did make me happy. And like, I do love books that are about, you know, the sad queer and like, you know, devastating stories and doomed love that, you know, ain't gonna ever go anywhere. And it's just nice to have a book where it's already been established, this relationship, and although there's ups and downs, you still like, you're still wanting it to be a good thing, and I guess like it is. And yeah, I would so recommend this. And I'm super excited to continue with the series, so let's go do that.
Now it's time for the second in the series, Upside of Unrequited. Let's see, can I get this out? Oh, yay. Here we go. Let's start it.
So I've been reading this. I'm about to up to page 148 now. I'm out, having a really crap day, to be honest, but whatever, what's new sometimes. But I'm enjoying it, I really am. I think this is still a little bit different to Simon because obviously I knew some of the plot. But yeah, I'm enjoying this. I'm really liking the main character. I'm really like feeling her and like feeling relatability as well. The minute I want to film and loads of people want to come by. Anyway, but I will tell you more about the plot later, I guess. I was going to do it now, but it's just, yeah, my battery's on like 15%, so yeah. Anyway, I'm just in the park. I'm going to try and just, you know, live in a moment and stop stressing about so much things. Sort of like the main character in this book, so it's relevant. And I will update you later. A bit better, read some more, just relaxing in the park. Yeah, definitely like nature, so much better than civilization. For me anyway. So yeah, I might sit for a bit on that bench, just have a look at the view. Let me turn you around because the view is really pretty. See, you can look for miles. I don't actually know, it's just a bit precarious, but I might just, you know, have a bit of a walk instead. Yeah. Pretty. Yo. So, Upside of Unrequited. This is following Molly Perskin Suso, who is the cousin of Abby, who is Simon's friend from Simonverse, Homo Sapiens and Agenda. So it's a book in the Simonverse, which there is four of, but it's not a book in the Creekwood series. That would be Leah on the Offbeat, but that came out after this, so I'm reading it in sort of like publication order, within the universe. And I feel like it's quite good to go a bit of a break from those characters to these new ones and then going back to them when I get to Leah. And she has a twin sister called Cassie, and she is like quite chubby, and it's just sort of like following her and her like dating life and how it is like in her body, in a sense. Cassie starts seeing this new girl called Mina, and her and Cassie sort of are trying to set her up with Will, who is Mina's friend. But there's also this new guy called Reed at a place where she's like working for the summer, and she's sort of like having feelings for both of them, in a sense. And we're just like following their lives, and also the parents. They was like sperm donor children, and they're like these two lesbian couple, Patty and Nadine, and they also have a younger brother called Xavier. Main parts of the plot, without really like spoiling it, but it's just about Molly trying to navigate like how she wants to move forward, and how she always feels that she's on the outside in some sense, because being a bigger person, she doesn't really want to put herself out there to get heartbroken or get rejected. And it just talks about a lot of like the way that like people see you in some sense, or like the things that you do to make sure you're not seen as well sometimes. And yeah, I've really feeling her, and just all about like the friendship group and how like you're feeling that other people are moving ahead faster than you are, and I'm like, I see you there, girl. I see you, sister. And also sort of like the growing apart of her and Cassie, being twins, and how like this turning from a we to a she and I sort of situation. And I just think it's been done really, really well. And I can't wait to continue on page 224. I had to stop because I was like on the bus reading. And I would hope to read some more. I don't know if I'll finish it. It's currently like 9:30, so probably not, but I might read some more later. I'm really, really enjoying this. I'm like loving every single part of it, but still, on the whole, it is very good. And excited to continue. What's in my mind as well is also about how she is sort of has lots of crushes, but she's never had any like kisses or any actual like boyfriends or relationships, and how other people in her life are, and just sort of like seeing like love sort of around the place. And like obviously you feel like proud and you want to be supportive of your friends and stuff when they having these like good things happen to them, but at the same time you're like, what about me? When's my turn? And I'm like, once again, I see you, sister. I see you, sister. Like, yeah, I'm so ingrained with her at the moment. So, yeah. So I finished Upside of Unrequited. It's like 3 a.m. now again. Is it like, yeah, I usually have that one, don't I? I really, really enjoyed this. I loved it. I just really liked how it came together. And Molly, I thought she was such a great main character. There was ups and downs, but I just like felt an affinity with her, and I just really loved her, like the messages. And it's not saying that like you need a boyfriend or you need someone for you to feel happy or beautiful or anything like that. It's more like you need to sort of put yourself out there and accept that rejection could be a thing, but also there's the what if that is a possibility, and sort of like understanding that. And I just love the way it like deals with these like thoughts and feelings of like friends moving like on quicker than you are, and just like what it's like to be sort of bigger as a teenager. And I really wish I read this like when I was younger as well, but hey ho, still learn from it hopefully, and you know, take some things on board myself, even though obviously it's different, but you know what I'm trying to say. I did my core pile, and this came out to be 4 stars, the same as Simon. Not like over the top, like I love it, I really, really enjoyed it. So I don't fully know what star rating I'm going to give. I'm going to say 4.5 for now. It might change. But I would really, really recommend it. And you don't really need to read Simon to read this because it is sort of like a standalone. It's not part of that series. But yeah. Now I'm going to go to sleep. But tomorrow I shall start Leah on the Offbeat. I won't show you get it out because that's a struggle. And I'll tell you what it's about then. I don't really know what it's about. All I know is that it's the sequel to Simon. And that is why I bought it in the charity shop. It was like £4 for £1. I was like, you know what? I'm probably going to get it. Like, I have the other one. Probably going to love that. Let's just get it. So I shall see you in the morning. And good night for now, I guess, even though you probably aren't gonna sleep in between these two clips, but I am, so yeah.
I didn't realize my copy was signed, not to me, but like to someone else. That's kind of cute, but yeah, to wear this like.
So, hey, so today I haven't actually started Leah. I've been doing other stuff, like some sorting and things. Listening to a lot of like Spice Girls and S7 and Bewitched, which has been fun. But I did finish another book, so I thought I'd take a little bit of a break from the series and try something else. I read this poetry collection called Crush by Richard Sykes, and it's really, really good. I would so recommend it. Totally unrelated to this video. But I'm probably going to give it about 4 stars, and some parts of this was like really, really good. But yeah, check my review for that. But I just made some risotto, so I'm gonna have that and then see if I can maybe read a bit later today. So let's do that. This update was so not needed, but I did it nonetheless.
TB, but it doesn't seem like symptoms of TB, so the main character is suspicious, and all the while that she stayed in this house.
Hello. It's been a couple days since like I updated you on the book. I'm at page like 254, so I think I've got about like 80-90 pages left. I wanted to read it this morning and try and get it done today, but I didn't think I will. I don't think I've said anything what it's about yet, if I remember correctly. But we're basically following Leah, who was Simon's like one of his best friends from Simon, and we still have like Nick obviously, and Abby, and Garrett and Bram and Morgan and Anna, I think, are like the two other ones that used to like sit at their table, and Simon's sisters Nora and Taylor as well. And I'm saying these other girls' names because they are all like in a band with Leah. She's sort of like really good at drumming, and it's sort of the book, the title is like how like she's offbeat in her actual life because Leah is bi and she wants to like tell people sort of, but also is like can't get there and like can't let actually say the words, even though she knows everyone's gonna be fine with it. It's just, you know, still a barrier to overcome. She is also like a bigger person, and I sort of like what comes with living in that type of body. It's sort of like her trying to figure out like who she likes. So like in their senior year, so then they're running up to prom, and also like moving on, like university and like where they're gonna go, and also like leaving and like, you know, going across the country and things. Her and like everyone else thinks that like she should be going out with Garrett because they're both single and they're sort of like bantery, flirty sort of moments. And she like likes him, she thinks he's cute and stuff, and that's like a viable option. But she's also like trying to work out her feelings for Abby and like if they're real or not, and just trying to like work different things out. And yeah, I was enjoying it to the start, not as much as Simon or Unrequited, but as it's just gone on, it's just gotten very messy, and it feels like Leah specifically, her like actions are sort of like a little bit like erratic, and it's just like quite like over the place. And I get it is a chaotic time, but the book as well just feels messy, and I don't really like Leah anymore. I find her quite like petty and irritating. And yeah, and it's sort of like ruining the series in a sense, because I really like some like the other characters and just like some of the things they're doing, like the way things are going on, and it's just quite like messy and over the place, and yeah, it's a shame. I don't really know what else to say about this, because I can't really say that much, because not all that much has really happened. It's just sort of messiness and sort of like trying to figure things out, which I get. But at the same time, it's not that enjoyable to read. And I don't really care for her all that much. But something I do like is that she sort of like deals with like money problems at home, and sort of like how that's like a focus on her mind. And it's sort of like different to her, all her friends and stuff, because they live in quite like a rich like area. And there's not like an issue for them, but she has to like constantly think about it. And sort of like her relationship with her mum as well. But yeah, it's not terrible. It's not bad, really. It's just messy.
See my belly.
Hey, so it was fun. I have to use like a Pringle tub to get a light. But anywho, I read honestly not much more than what I left on, to be honest. 274. I'm really not enjoying it anymore. Leah is just. She's just become so like cynical and annoying and just like a nasty person. And it's not a spoiler, but like if someone comes out to you, don't make it about yourself. Like it's just such a dick move and just really frustrating. And I get that things are going on in your own life, but someone is trying to, you know, say something sincere and get something off their own chest and to sort of bring it all around to how that impacts you. Not, you know, not being a good person. This is sort of ruining Simon for me, especially the character of Leah here. And I'm failing to care. But I probably will finish it. Anywho, that's a little update. See you soon, I guess. So I just finished Leon Offbeat. I guess it ended alright, and I still care for most of the characters and Leah as well. Just things wasn't fully rounded up as I would have liked to. And it just a bit irritated me, like what I was saying earlier about someone coming out and not, you know, taking it at face value and like bringing it all towards yourself. Wasn't really resolved, which was a bit frustrating. And yeah, I don't know what to think about this. Personally, I would not recommend it, especially if you enjoyed Simon quite a lot. But it is good at like showing the experience of someone as they're nearing the end of their like high school experience, like questioning a lot about like the future and like who they are and things like that. But I just didn't care for her, and it made it quite a bit of a slog to get through from about the 40% mark until the end, basically. So yeah, I think for star rating, maybe like a 2.75. But yep, I'm now going to read the little novella Love Creekwood. I've got that on my laptop because I don't have a physical copy of it, so I will do that and tell you what it's about. I think it's just sort of like emails, correspondence from like different people, like as they're at uni now, but I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, let's do that and update you soon. Hello. So it's the next day. I finished Love Creekwood like the afternoon just now. I thought it was fine. It was, yeah, it was enjoyable. It's basically just email correspondences between the different characters that we've already come across with each other, and some like group ones as well. And like they're at university now, and it's sort of about missing each other and like long distance relationships in a way, and like how they're getting on with like their courses and thinking of like future somewhat. So yeah, I thought some parts are a little bit repetitive, and you're just like, come on. There's a lack of like Nick's voice. I thought like, because he is like one of the main characters in the other books, there isn't really like any like emails from him, which is a little bit strange, I don't know. Also, I feel like some of the actual plot points would have been really interesting to discuss and uncover within an actual like novel, and like the like longing and like the way they're grappling with like the changes from school to university and things like that. But on the whole, it was fine. I think I'll probably give it maybe about a 3.5 star rating. But yeah, I would recommend it, I guess, if you're reading the series. So we've come to the end of this video, and I just thought I would quickly do a ranking of the books. Worst place is definitely Leah on the Offbeat. I've downgraded this to 2.5 stars, and I would probably put it as 2 on Goodreads, because I've read some other reviews and I'm like, you know what, yeah, the characters all just seem really off, and I just did not like this book. I would not recommend it. To be honest, I feel like just stick with Simon and read that as like another one in the universe. But yeah, that's the worst one. Then probably Love Creekwood. It was fine, but like I didn't love it. Then Simon vs. Homosapiens Agenda. Would really recommend this book. I wish I had read it when I was younger and more at the time, but I still, you know, give it a read now. But the favourite is Upside of Unrequited. I really, really enjoyed this story. I really love the character, really like resonated with her, and I'd love to maybe like see more of her story, or something like that possibly. But yeah, I'm really happy with how this ended, and I would really recommend it, and you can like read this as a standalone as well without the rest of the actual Creekwood series. So yeah, that was this reading vlog. I expected it to be done a lot earlier than this, but just Leah just slugged. But anywho's, I hope you enjoyed it, and I shall see you very soon. Have a nice morning, evening, night, wherever you are in the world. Bye.